Hello, folks. This is Athril. Welcome back to Oxenfree. Hopefully, we will not be plagued by the recording issues that we were struggling with last time, so let's start.
Jesus, that house is huge! That lady really knew how to live.
It's like the Chateau des
Ad... How did she get so rich if she was just like a communications person or whatever in the military?
I think I said when we got here, her family like owned part of the island or something. I think she just inherited a lot, honestly.
Right. There's like a ledger here. The Adler family does own the island. And here's a combination for a padlock to a chest is all it says. 291854.
A chest? Have you seen one yet?
Negative, but maybe I just missed it. She made a lot of... What should I call these slides? They're not videos.
Silent memories?
There's something in here.
Just looks like vacation slides or something.
It's like a boat that needs keys. There are no oars.
And before we go crazy, it wasn't with Maggie's stuff back at the office, like with the radio?
No. We looked through all of her stuff, I think.
Huh. Well,
the keys, they have to be in the house for the movers or her family, you know?
That's as good a guess as any.
Sometimes when I lock myself out of my house, I can't help but just stare at the deadbolt, trying to, like, hypnotize it to open or something. You ever do that?
Not really. But we can try that now if you think it'll help.
It's a radio lock. The woman sure did love her antiquated security.
That is a nifty gizmo.
Finally.
Carissa,
oh, God,
Jesus.
You scared me. Thought you were like Maggie Adler's dead body or something.
How would that make sense? How do you get in here? The door was locked. Do you have, like, a radio?
No, I don't have a radio. The kitchen window was open.
Kitchen window? Where?
In the back. In the kitchen?
Okay, sure. Look, Clarissa's here, so everyone's here now. We can just... Everyone's okay, all right? That's a good thing.
Yeah, let's just find the keys to the boat, or a phone, or whatever, and just find a way home. I promise, we can all keep talking and or fighting at school on Monday.
Yes. Fine, okay? Let's focus up.
Everybody find something and hope that it helps.
Man, she owned enough books. It's mostly math, I think. Ergodic thermodynamics. And religion. Sheesh,
okay,
there's a lot of...
Okay, we get it. She liked the smell of paper. Fascinating insight. We'll all miss her dearly.
Okay, why don't you get off your ass and help then?
I am helping, by keeping out of the way of more enterprising sorts like yourself.
Ugh.
Oh, that's an attic? Thought it was like a cat's toy or something.
Attics are always a little haunted house spooky, right?
It's the tight spaces, the darkness, the spiders, the creaking, and... Well, that about covers it.
Ooh, you know what? This might be the chest that takes that combination. 29, 18, 54. It's a lot of radios and those containers we saw at the town office. Oh, and like a map of the caverns. She's written here, tune into the source.
What do you think that means? She couldn't have known about the ghosts, right?
She must have figured it out, that there were ghosts here and the potential for them to be running amok.
I guess that's a possibility. Is this... Ah, the boat keys. Got them.
Perfecto.
All right, we got keys for the boat. Where?
I got the keys. They were in the attic upstairs.
In a chest. But who cares? Let's just go.
Alex. Oh, Alex. Come down here, please.
We have something we want to show you.
Clarissa, what's going on?
You're confused, aren't you? Well, you should be. How does it go? Things are different, except in a different way. Just come downstairs so we can get started.
Nona, are you okay? Wake up! Ren, come on, we got a boat to catch, buddy.
There you are. Now we imagine you're a bit confused. But don't fret. This will be the final part of your training, Alex.
All training is supervised by very skilled instructors.
Thank you, Radio.
Training? I don't want to be trained. What are
you signed up for this, Alexandra? In the caverns, you tuned in to our signal. So please, I cannot bear your excuses, offspring.
How was I meant to know what the hell was gonna happen?
And yet, without understanding your footing, you still acted. But don't worry. The test is easy.
We will speak of something we see on the house.
And you will go and find it. See? As simple and good-humored as...
What if I don't, huh? What if I just stand here and don't go along with this?
Refusal to cooperate will incur grim penalties, I'm afraid, but it's your choice. Now, let's start with a softball. I spy, with my little eye... Radiation.
There is, of course, a time limit here.
So...
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. Once they call it the fish alive.
4, 3, 2.
I'm
sorry, child. You weren't even close.
Nona!
Look at that!
Where is she? Where'd you take her?
Don't you mind, but let this be a teachable moment for you. If you'd paid attention, you'd have noticed the television set right by my side, the little X-ray emitting death machine. But right now, you'd be wise to think of radiation
in another sense. Pay attention.
What does this have to do with us? I mean,
I spy.
With my little eye, a notch. Let's make this a little harder, okay?
8, 7, 6, 5, 4.
Is it this painting? It looks kind of like a knot.
Excellent, excellent. You're doing so well. It's time for the bonus round, Alex, so stay quick.
This is one you really want to find.
I spy with my little eye a picture of a memory. Be fast.
The picture of... I guess it's Maggie, Adler, and somebody. Is this it?
Yes, very
nice.
That's Margaret
Adler and her friend Anna.
See,
You and your schoolyard chums are experiencing, well, this has sort of happened before. Maggie and Anna tried to sport with us many years ago and, well, only one survived. And in the process, we discovered a way for us to return, so to speak. It just takes a little time.
Wait, what? What happened to Anna?
Let's leave it at the poor girl didn't know what she was playing with.
It doesn't matter. They're not an eternal recurrence. The waves. It's the waves, we think. And we will use those waves to absorb into your friends as sunlight blooms into flowers.
And we will grow. And we will engulf.
Wait, what? What happens to them after you're absorbed?
Their form will exist with us inside. It will be a swap, you see, of essences, I guess you could call them. We tried it too quickly with Anna, but now we know
to wait and soak.
We had to keep you here, on the island. It will be a great honor, Alex,
really, to carry us through this life
and on to the next.
Please just don't do this. We're not-
It's sad, I know, to lose the facility to feel, to be, but we have not felt anything for a very long time.
And we'll do whatever is necessary.
When our vessel dashed on the rocks, we had until dawn, and so will you. We would spend that time wisely, and we thank you for your good service.
Well, that could have gone better. He should go to school here. Okay, seriously, who are you?
So we can go on. I think I'm gonna be sick.
Me first.
It wasn't a dream or a vision or something. You and Clarissa standing in the living room just now, was it?
No, that was very, very real.
And look, Alex, if you're ever getting asked to find someone's crap, lest ghosts are gonna punish not you, ask to tag out or something, because God, that felt like my skin was getting pulled off.
Normally, she's good at this stuff. Normally.
I'm sorry, all right? I tried my best. I mean, when things are jumping all around, it's tough to even know what she was talking about.
So, I mean, Christ, if Clarissa was whisked away to the cave by nuclear submarine monsters, then, I mean, the plan has to be to retrieve her, right?
I'm still going to call them ghosts, if that's okay.
A ghost is a monster, so...
No, completely, that's the plan. Of course it is. Clarissa is not going to be the human sponge for some evil island ghosts. Not on my watch.
Well, if we're going to the cave... Oh, actually, I forgot. I saw the entrance has been caved in since you guys went inside.
All right, I know there are a whole bunch of secret communist bomb-fearing tunnels dug into this place during the 1950s, and Maggie has loads of film about military stuff in her basement, so...
Maybe there's a way back into the cave through one of those, you're thinking?
Let's take a look.
What kind of name is Epiphany Fields, anyway? Wait, is it Epiphany?
It's Epiphany Field.
Oh, that makes more sense.
Thank you.
I can't pause. Why can't I pause? It's definitely doing something odd here.
Jesus, that house is huge. That lady really knew how to live.
It's like the Chateau de...
How did she get so rich if she was just like a communications person or whatever in the military?
I think I said when we got here, her family like owned part of the island or something. I think she just inherited a lot, honestly.
There's something in here.
Just looks like vacation slides or something.
Huh. Ren, you were right. There's like a ledger here. The Adler family does own the island. And here's a combination for a padlock to a chest is all it says. 29, 18, 54.
A chest? Have you seen one yet?
Negative, but maybe I just missed it. She made a lot of... what should I call these slides? They're not videos.
Silent memories?
It's like a boat that needs keys. There are no oars.
And before we go crazy, it wasn't with Maggie's stuff back at the office, like with the radio?
No. We looked through all of her stuff, I think.
Huh. Well,
Keys, they have to be in the house for the movers or her family, you know?
That's as good a guess as any.
A radio lock. The woman sure did love her antiquated security.
That is a nifty gizmo.
Finally.
Carissa,
oh, God,
Jesus.
You scared me. Thought you were like Maggie Adler's dead body or something.
How do you get in here? The door was locked. Do you have, like, a radio?
No, I don't have a radio. The kitchen window was open.
Kitchen window? Where?
In the back. In the kitchen.
I don't believe you. These windows don't even... they don't work like that.
How would you know? You've never been here.
Look, Clarissa's here, so everyone's here now. We can just... everyone's okay, all right? That's a good thing.
Yeah, let's just find the keys to the boat or a phone or whatever and just find a way home. I promise. We can all keep talking and or fighting.
Fine, okay? Let's focus up.
Everybody find something and hope that it helps.
Man, she owned enough books. It's mostly math, I think. Ergodic thermodynamics. And religion. Sheesh,
okay,
there's a lot of...
Okay, we get it. She liked the smell of paper. Fascinating insight. We'll all miss her dearly.
Okay, why don't you get off your ass and help then?
I am helping, by keeping out of the way of more enterprising sorts like yourself.
Ugh. How are you doing?
How are you doing?
I think about as bad as everybody else right now. I feel like I've been run over with a truck. With... acid wheels, if that makes sense.
Yeah, that's pretty much been the slogan of the night. We'll make shirts when we get home.
Oh, it's a draft of her letter that she left in the office. To whom it should concern. She left notes everywhere, she said. Hidden with secret signals.
She was an odd one, I'll give her that. But, you know, cool in a way.
No, I think it's pretty cool, actually. I could see myself doing something like this for the... the people I leave behind.
Well, leave a cheat sheet for the laziest of us, okay?
Wait, have you seen this? It's like a star map or a diagram of planets or something.
Yeah, why would she need anything like a map of the universe? I mean, it's not like she's bouncing stuff off satellites for a job. Or maybe they were back then, what do I know?
Maybe they needed to chart signals through space or something?
Maybe. Oh, that's an attic? Thought it was like a cat's toy or something.
Attics are always a little haunted house spooky, right?
It's the tight spaces, the darkness, the spiders, the creaking, and... well, actually, that about covers it.
Ooh, you know what? This might be the chest that takes that combination. 29-18-54. It's a lot of radios and those containers we saw at the town office. Oh, and like a map of the caverns. She's written here, tune into the source.
What do you think that means? She couldn't have known about the ghosts, right?
Tune into the source. It's probably something about the special radios, you know?
Huh. Is this... ah, the boat keys. Got 'em.
Perfecto.
All right, we got keys for the boat. Where?
I got the keys. They were in the attic upstairs.
In a chest. But who cares? Let's just go.
Alex. Oh, Alex. Come down here, please.
We have something we want to show you.
Clarissa, what's going on?
You're confused, aren't you?
Nona, come on, honey. It's time to motor. Ren, come on. We got a boat to catch, buddy. Jonas, up and at 'em.
Ah, there you are. Now we imagine you're a bit confused. But don't fret. This will be the final part of your training, Alex.
All training is supervised by very skilled instructors.
Training? I don't want to be trained. What are you...
You signed up for this, Alexandra. In the caverns, you tuned in to our signal.
So please, I cannot bear your excuses, offspring.
I wish I hadn't tuned into that stupid thing, okay? If I knew what it was gonna do, do you really think I would have even brought this radio?
Shh. It's okay. Everything will be fine. The test is easy. We will speak of something we see in the house. You will go and find it. See? As simple and good humor.
What is it with you guys and all the games? You're like dogs or children. Just what is the point?
The point, dear, the point is that they were never games. And you can figure that out by your lonesome. Now, let's start with a softball. I spy, with my little eye, radiation.
There is, of course, a time limit here.
So,
are you talking about the TV?
Very good.
Well done.
The older models
emitted X-rays.
But right now, you'd be wise to think of radiation.
In another sense. Pay attention.
What does this have to do with us? I mean, we're
I spy.
With my little eye, a notch. Let's make this a little harder, okay?
8 7 6 5
Is it this painting? It looks kind of like a knot.
Excellent. You're doing so well. It's time for the bonus round, Alex, so stay quick.
This is one you'll really want to find.
I spy with my little eye a picture of a memory.
Be fast now.
The picture of I guess it's Maggie Adler and somebody. Is this it?
Yes, very
nice.
That's
Margaret Adler and her friend Anna.
See, you and your schoolyard chums are experiencing, well, this has sort of happened before. Maggie and Anna
tried to
sport with us many years ago and,
well,
only one survived. But in the process, we discovered a way for us to return,
so to speak. It just takes a little time. And a far-reaching tolerance for the ignorant.
Wait, what? What happened to Anna?
Let's leave it at the poor girl didn't know
what she was playing with. It doesn't matter. The knot of eternal recurrence. The waves. It's the waves, we think. And we will use those waves to absorb into your friends as sunlight blooms into flowers.
And we will grow. And we will engulf.
Wait, what happens to them after you're absorbed?
Their form will exist with us inside. It will be a swap, you see, of essences, I guess you could call them. We tried it too quickly with Anna, but now we know
to wait and soak.
We had to keep you here, on the island. It will be a great honor, Alex, really, to carry us through this life. And on to the next.
There has to be another way. I mean, just maybe. I mean, maybe I can do something with the radio.
We never had our time. It was ripped from us. We watched the universe's conception fly to its demise over and over and over again. You don't know what it's been like. But how could you?
What you're doing is wrong, and you know that.
Any integrity we once had drowned in the reef ages ago. When our vessel dashed on the rocks, we had until dawn. And so will you. We would spend that time wisely. And we thank you for your good service.
So, I'm kind of screwed. He should go out on his own. Okay, seriously, who are you?
So we can go on. I think I'm gonna be sick.
Me first.
It wasn't a dream or a vision or something. You and Clarissa standing in the living room just now, was it?
No, that was very, very real.
We're in, like, trouble.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, let's try again. I'm gonna have to do so much video editing. Oh boy. Okay, here we go.
Be careful, that film's really flammable. Wouldn't want Smoke and Johnny to light the house on fire.
Ha ha.
All right, there's already something in here. Experiments and findings of experienced phenomena, January 52.
Awesome. Oh man, if this turns out to be just prehistoric home videos.
Yeah.
I'm sure this is just the,
open. It's sweet, they're learning.
Boo!
Okay, all right, we get it.
You can, skip this one, Alex.
Okay, we're getting warmer, I think.
So, if you look at the, like, lines or whatever, the bomb shelter should lead right into the cave. Just like from another angle. According to this, at least.
Oh, so it does.
But won't it be, like, locked or something, right?
Yeah, how do we get in? It's just like the cave wall, only steel or whatever bomb shelters are made out of.
Oh, what? She knew about these things?
Wow, that's crazy.
It says that to fix a temporal tear, that's a mouthful, in the cave, we would need to transpose to the other side and tune into the source within itself.
Okay, but we're not doing that, right?
Good question.
Yeah, that's going a little above and beyond.
Well, I don't know what to tell you, but strap in, boys and girls, because we might have to, okay? If it's the only thing that will fix us.
Yeah, but that's, like, scary.
Well, something better work.
Or we're boned.
Or we're boned. Precisely.
Oh, sorry. This looks like the end, but from the wrong film thing.
No. Wait. This is something I actually remember from that stupid radio tour thing, because it, like, sounded so weird. It's called the call and response system. It unlocks the bomb shelter. This is showing us how to do it. See? It says, when someone sends an emergency signal from the Catbird station in the woods, and the receiving station confirms it. It's like a connected response thing.
Brilliant!
Really?
It's good enough for me.
Alex and me will head through the woods, do the, call part. You and Ren can hang by the door to the bomb shelter and open it when it's ready.
Can we just, like, think this plan through for, like, 1 minute before running off half-cocked?
Everyone heard that, right?
Yes.
Don't we need, like, access codes or something like that?
Actually, I doubt it. It'll probably be tied to, like, the military radios and, well, we stole them, so.
Well, the system works.
Okay.
All right, break. And if anything goes wrong, please, don't tell me. I won't want to know.
We won't.
Some letters.
Oh, Maggie says she hopes the notes are found by the correct person. Well, I guess that'll have to be us.
Whoever is finding these notes, understand my hope is that by enshrouding this intelligence in such an obtuse manner, the detection will discourage most innocent seekers, thereby allowing it to befall the correct person and not easily distracted military mind or typical bewildered excursionist. Do not blame the submarine's crew. I don't believe his pastors like Henry Griffin can even understand what's truly happening to them. And do not have to forgive me for my myriad failures, but please remember my name, the name Anna Shea. Know that she did not deserve her fate.
Woman Marianne Bozic helped her transcribe the ghost's transmissions.
Marianne Bozic, forever engraved on the command's annex memorial plaque, was a kind, humble woman who helped me decode the ghost's unusual messages. I don't think she ever really believed my hypothesis that they were relays from a sunken submarine, even though she corresponded with, as she put it, a man named Calvin, an electrician who died on the Kanaloa. I pieced together the truth, the cover-up, and my own tragic mistake that killed him and his mates over months of careful deciphering.
Data Command Annex, as it had been dubbed, was used during the base's early years.
Thank you. tells you the, like, name of it. That's new.
Alex, okay, are you back to normal?
I just saw, it was like a premonition, I think, and I know that sounds whatever, but this must be what it's like when people say they do that, because I kind of just saw Ren drowning.
Okay, just take it easy for a second. You went all red-eyed, like when we get possessed.
I did?
You stopped walking and started mumbling, and then your eyes lit up like little road flares. It only lasted like a minute, but we should hurry up and do this before the door on you opens any wider to them.
But the thing with Ren, it was so real. It was like I was there with him. Maybe we should go back.
But I'm sure he's fine, so let's finish what we started.
Steady, protective, and ever vigilant of enemies, both. Sentry, sculpted by Lieutenant Peter Hasborough. It was installed.
Thank you.
A low-frequency radio wave is incident upon a body of radio waves travel forever until it is absorbed by matter or a person.
Al 7.
Maggie brought her friend Anna here to help, I guess.
When people in the comms department began transferring off, I was able to convince my higher-ups, including coincidentally one eventual army passenger aboard the Cunalora, Henry Griffin, to bring Anna on board as replacement. Anna had been working within broadcasting, so it made enough sense to stay upper ranks. Incidentally, when I dream, it's usually during this time period, amidst the change, and I am trying to prevent Anna from ever coming.
Orderly!
Charlie 6.
Every individual it is maintained is enveloped in a radiant, invisible to the common eye, and only perceived by the soul accustomed to it.
Orderly!
In the middle of things. Time for Fina, Lima. Echo, Echo, Papa. In the middle of things. Time for Fina, Lima. Echo. In the middle of things.
Thank you.
must find them all.
Communication school here taught them how to make codes.
Recruits learn communication technology here, and several others learn code breaking. It's true, but due to my aptitude in math and mechanical engineering, I was assigned code making, specifically ciphers in which to conceal projects for even other government agencies. It was a job I grew increasingly uncomfortable with, and my keen interest in radio science had me pulling double duty as a comms officer. I remember one in Kanaloa's engineers, Francis, calling me a radio woman. As far as he knew, it was my only job. So I can find any things I missed. I still have 4 more Nautilus to find. I don't think I realized there were anomalies to find.
She was working at the tower the morning they sank.
I was on watch duty in the tower when it happened, having just gotten back from an early leave from the reading of my father's will. For years, I childishly blamed him for this, too, his one last act against me. But it was nobody's fault or decision but my own. I'm sure it was Francis Sattler who sent me Conelo's distress signal. It had been cut off, I still don't know why, and I had hastily interpreted the garbled transmission as an attempt to jam radar. And so I sent back a guidebook. Back the guidebook recommendation to scout and bomb if necessary. I love this game's mod. I just wish I could walk faster.
You know what time it is?
It's 4 a.m, which is usually about the time everyone decides if they're going to bed or ordering another 3 pizzas.
Yeah? What's your vote usually in that situation?
Never leave pizza on the table. It's like getting 11 in blackjack. Just double down. Don't even think about it.
You think this tuning into the tear thing's gonna work? Like, really?
It really doesn't matter if I think it's gonna work. It's sort of all we have, and we're running out of time.
It is all we have, yeah. I just wish I felt
I
like the ghosts were concerned
stuff
that their
is
plan
getting
won't
pulled
work.
In from, like, their time or something. This is so weird.
Yeah, it's not exactly a good omen. I think we're running out of runway here.
I guess Maggie was the one who had this place turned into a park.
After the port closed, I used the considerable resources from my father's endowment to buy most of the land, or influence government officials to declare that which I could not buy protected. I have not been entirely successful, and I have watched in horror as a small tourist industry has precariously sprung up on this cursed island. Even the family of one of the sailors who died, Kevin Gilbert, set up a restaurant to cater to inquisitive out-of-towners. I can promise this, though. The museum will never happen, and the beach and caves will be boarded up.
When he was stationed at Fort Milner, Colonel Tim Russell would frequently wander the woods west of his barracks and sketch the wildlife he'd encounter on his walks. After the fort closed in 1974, he led a petition to make the land federally protected, and in 1988, he succeeded. Now, Edwards Forest is an internationally recognized wildlife refuge and bird sanctuary.
Now the station's up at the top of the hill. I hope this works. Now the station's up at the top of the hill. I hope this works.
God, we're in another loop-de-loo. They always come at the most appropriate times, don't they?
Yeah, they do. Thanks for the update. Now the station's up at the top of the hill. I hope this works.
Yep, I am also... hope that.
Ren! Nona, what happened? What's wrong with Ren?
He had an accident. He died. I couldn't...
Oh my god, Ren. I can't believe this.
What happened?
He drowned. He took a fall. I don't know. He just stopped.
I mean, does it really matter what happened?
Either way, done is done. And done in this case is particular.
It's Ren, whatever you want to call it. I know you're doing it. Just fix it.
It's not us doing it, dear. We weren't lying. The time loops, as you've taken to calling them, which we do find so adorable, are of your own making.
Yeah, sure. Just like you infesting us like lice isn't your fault either.
That we have and will own up to, but the other stuff, that we're afraid is on you. Alex, we know you're in charge and we know your plan, and we also know that your plan won't work. It never does. So we have a proposition for you. A deal. A bargain, really.
A proposition? Like what?
It's already over for Phyllis, and she's gone. We'll pilot her through the rest of existence, and there's nothing you can do to change that. But, if you agree to let us take her, let her go, quietly and without fuss, you won't slaughter the rest of your friends, like young Reginald here. We leave the rest of you cattle alone. We only really need the...
I don't get it. Why do you even need my permission if you have her already?
Don't misunderstand. We don't need anything from you except what we can willingly take. We're merely offering you an arrangement that would leave both parties satisfied. Well, somewhat satisfied.
Oh, forget it. No deal. Everyone is coming home with me.
Courage is not always the way, dear. You don't have much time left. Do you know how we know you don't have much time left?
Fine. Shoot. How do you know?
We know because we can be Jonas for this long, and his soul's as quiet as an empty church.
Just never say we didn't provide you all the rules.
He was your best friend, Alex. I'm sorry. I don't know what happened. One minute he was there, and then he was just gone.
It's okay, Nona. You didn't do anything wrong. I know it's not your fault. Of course it's not your fault.
I didn't know him that well, but I like what I'd gotten to know. I'm sorry. I shouldn't. It's colossally stupid of me to talk about him like that with you here. This is...
He was more important.
It's not stupid. It's not small to like somebody. It doesn't diminish anything.
Maybe. It's a tiny thing, but I hope he knew that I liked him. And I don't know if he did.
He knew, Nona. Don't worry. He knew.
Like I said, it's a tiny thing. But thanks, Alex.
The station's up at the top of the... Ugh. God, that was... My mouth feels like I just ate a tree.
Do you remember Ren? Nona? Their whole little situation?
Yeah, I mean, maybe it was just a version of things, you know? Like it didn't happen in this time, or...
Yeah. No, maybe.
Hello?
Anyone there?
What? Are they... Oh, they're somehow... I guess they're somehow broadcasting or something from the, station speakers.
Are you guys at the station?
Anybody? Jonas?
They're both alive.
Jonas,
that's
punch
all
Alex if you can hear this.
God.
Yeah, no, that's
seriously,
a bonus.
Seriously, right in the throat.
Jonas, don't listen. We're all set here for the thing? The machinery's beacon hug or whatever we're doing?
Yeah, let's do it. Time's wasted.
She thinks that the ghosts were pushed out of our reality and maybe aren't actually dead?
My belief, bolstered by Anna's and my research conducted largely at the Catbird Station, where interruptions were rare, is the men and women of the USS Kanaloa were separated from our dimensional existence by the implosion of the submarine's nuclear reactor. Identified one passenger, Henry, by his call sign, and his confused diction and reliance on game logic, says to me that their emotional states, if not mental states, have been reduced to that of children. A thought I cling to when I envision Anna's demise.
Like, actually wasted! Like, I feel my body wasting away!
No, it's okay if you're, like, dealing with stuff. We had to deal with stuff.
What stuff?
When I almost kind of slipped and fell off the bridge.
Oh my god, you guys, that was...
No, it was this.
It was psychotic to watch. Like, almost doesn't quite describe the terror that held my heart watching her come close.
It wasn't that.
You were perilously close to tumbling into the ocean from like 5,000 feet up.
It wasn't that high.
With anything or expose it.
It was like charity. It was high. Shall discuss believe it me. Prudently.
No, it wasn't.
So yeah, it was.
No, it. Just whatever. I'm fine.
She is fine. It's true.
Shut up.
With anything or expose it. With charity,
okay, just
shall discuss it prudently.
Whenever you're ready, because I'm sure you're listening.
Yeah, just hit the button, the receiver thing, and we can do this stuff.
Stuff, exactly.
Okay, over.
Over now.
Find fault with anything.
Why do you have to have a last word? Over's
with
good
charity,
enough.
The abbot shall discuss it.
Over now.
Lest perchance God has sent him for this very thing.
Easy.
If indeed he find fault with anything, or expose it, with charity, the abbot shall discuss it prudently.
No, I'm still on my computer over there.
Well, how do you know you're Bobby Dunbar?
I know who I am, and I know who you are, and nothing else makes a difference.
Dox 6.
Well, how do you know you're Bobby Dunbar?
I know who I am, and I know who you are, and nothing else makes a difference.
Dox 6.
Well, how do you know you're Bobby Dunbar?
I know who I am, and I know who you are.
Right, radio locked. I keep forgetting this thing is that. Okay, I just have to tune it.
Emergency. How may I help you? If you're being sat on by a very large burglar, just mash the dial with your fist, please. Otherwise, stay on the line, and we'll send a traffic custodian out to you directly.
It is so nice to hear you two finding the sunny side of all this.
We are.
Well, he is.
We both are. Don't let her fool you.
Signal verified. Shelter TF1 open.
Nice.
I guess it worked.
Great. Okay, we'll meet you there.
Right. See you at the shelter.
Over and out.
Okay, still need a couple more. What is the front lady?
Mr. Jordan, couldn't we have him?